Technology opens up a world of knowledge to anyone with an internet connection. Apps help us learn a language. Online courses help us get better at our jobs. How do we decide which brands to choose? And how do our choices affect performance? New research by MIT Sloan's Renée Richardson Gosline provides answers.
So past studies have established this effect called the marketing placebo effect, which is very much in line with medical placebo effects. If you have a higher status brand associated with a product, you will experience higher performance. When people were asked to do cognitive tasks using a pen emblazoned with the MIT logo, they felt more intelligent and performed better than the pen without the logo.
But Gosline's latest research finds that when it comes to learning, premium brands may hurt performance.
What we were surprised to find, actually, is that in a variety of learning contexts, these placebo effects work in the reverse direction. There's this paradox where people are feeling this confidence, but performing worse.
Does this mean that the promise of digital learning and training is squandered?
When we gain access to these rarefied air sort of brands, we need to ensure that they're working for us as tools, that the dynamic between our brands and ourselves is one where we dominate, where we are not subordinate, and where we don't feel like we're somehow gaining entrance to a place that we either don't deserve or don't belong.
The internet offers unprecedented access to educational opportunities. But Gosline says more must be done to examine the unconscious barriers that brand status creates.
The recommendation here is that leaders in organizations and premium brands themselves need to really be more welcoming to people of different sorts, so that when, for instance, someone gains admission to a high-status university through an online program, they feel that they truly have gained access.